Welcome to the SCP Foundation Integrated File Server. To begin, please insert your Foundation personnel badge into the card reader. Authorization. Approved. Please select item's numerical code to view. Processing. Your file is ready to view.
And the winner is. Before I announce the winner, Assistant Site Director Edmund said to the small group of researchers gathered in Site 73's cafeteria, "I'd just like to thank and congratulate all of you for participating. This has been a difficult year for us, and activities like this always help staff morale. I've enjoyed reading all your submissions, yes, Greg, even yours, and it was very difficult for the judges to pick a winner." With that out of the way, he said as he opened the envelope in his hands, "The winner of this year's Site 73 short story contest is Dr. Tom Malthus, for his story Night of the Revenge of the Wrath of the Ghost of the Fury." The 24 or so assembled authors clapped politely as Dr. Malthus rose from his seat, took a short bow, and accepted the $100 gift card that was his grand prize. Later, in his office, Dr. James Anderson, Associate Managing Supervisor of Temporal Anomaly Research, cursed to himself under his breath. Malthus had won? His story was a ridiculous B-movie parody. He'd put so much time into his own submission, a self-referential piece about a man who'll do anything to win a writing contest, only to be outdone by this over-the-top piece of hack work that Malthus wrote in about 15 minutes and submitted 2 hours before the deadline. "Well," he said to himself, "it's over and done with now. I can't change the past." Or could he? His position gave him research access to a number of SCP objects that operated outside of linear time. It would be a major violation of protocol if he got caught, of course, but as he went about his work, he idly wondered to himself whether there was any way he could use any of the objects he knew about to change the outcome of the contest. 982? Not likely. 728? Too unpredictable. 276? Maybe, but there's no way he could pull it off without getting caught. 869? 869. He'd overseen experiments in the past that involved using SCP-869 to attempt to send information back through time. It'd be risky, but if it worked, he'd have had the satisfaction of seeing the look on Malthus' face when he himself came out on top. If nothing else, he could call it just another experiment, right? It wasn't for 6 months that he worked up the courage to prepare his parcel. An envelope with a 1948 postage stamp affixed to it, addressed to Site 73. Inside it, another envelope marked with the Foundation's seal and instructions not to open it until decades later, the day the site writing contest was announced. Within that, a third envelope, to be delivered to his own office, and within that, a copy of Malthus' story and a letter to himself instructing him to submit it as his contest entry. Anderson was on pins and needles the entire drive to Galveston, the entire time bluffing his way past the guards at the entrance of SCP-869, the entire time he made his way past the crowds of people enjoying the park on that sunny summer day in 1948. Looking over his shoulder to make sure nobody else from the Foundation was following him, he made his way out the front entrance of the park, crossed the street, walked down the block to a waiting mailbox, opened it, and dropped his missive in. And the winner of this year's Site 73 short story contest is Dr. James Anderson, for his story Night of the Revenge of the Wrath of the Ghost of the Fury. The 24 or so assembled authors clapped politely as Dr. Anderson rose from his seat, took a short bow, and accepted the $100 gift card that was his grand prize. Success. Anderson was on cloud 9 as he made his way back to his office. When the office gopher first handed him a letter that purported to be from his future self, he thought he was being set up. The story it instructed him to submit was frankly ridiculous, and he wasn't even sure almost until the end of the contest that he wanted to submit it, but he did, and it had worked. He'd take himself out for a nice steak dinner that night to celebrate. He never did, however, bother to write himself a letter. And the winner of this year's Site 73 short story contest is Dr. Tom Malthus, for his story Night of the Revenge of the Wrath of the Ghost of the Fury. The two dozen or so assembled authors clapped politely as Dr. Malthus rose from his seat, took a short bow, and accepted the $100 gift card that was his grand prize. Later, in his office, Dr. James Anderson, Associate Managing Supervisor of Temporal Anomaly Research, cursed to himself under his breath. Malthus had won? His story was a ridiculous B-movie parody. He'd put so much time into his own submission, a self-referential piece about a man who'll do anything to win a writing contest, only to be outdone by this over-the-top piece of hack work that Malthus wrote in about 15 minutes and submitted 2 hours before the deadline. Well, he said to himself, it's over and done with now. I can't change the past. Or could he? And the winner of this year's Site 73 short story contest is Dr. James Anderson, for his story Night of the Revenge of the Wrath of the Ghost of the Fury. The two dozen or so assembled authors clapped politely as Dr. Anderson rose from his seat, took a short bow, and accepted the $100 gift card that was his grand prize. Success. Anderson was on cloud nine as he made his way back to his office. When the office gopher first handed him a letter that purported to be from his future self, he thought he was being set up. The story it instructed him to submit was frankly ridiculous, and he wasn't even sure almost until the end of the contest that he wanted to submit it, but he did, and it had worked. He'd take himself out for a nice steak dinner that night to celebrate. It wasn't until 30 years later, his last month on the job before retirement, as he cleaned a career's worth of paperwork out of his filing cabinet, that he rediscovered the certificate he'd been given to commemorate his victory. He realized that he'd never closed the time loop by sending himself a letter with a story in it, and he'd better do so fast, because if he left the foundation without ever having done so, 30 years of history could wind up in flux. He searched through his papers for hours looking for a copy of the story that had won him that contest so many years ago, in vain. I'll just have to improvise, he thought to himself, as he sat down at his computer and began typing out the story as best as he could remember it after all these years. And the winner of this year's Site 73 short story contest is Dr. Tom Malthus, for his story Night of the Revenge of the Wrath of the Ghost of the Fury. The two dozen or so assembled authors clapped politely as Dr. Malthus rose from his seat, took a short bow, and accepted the $100 gift card that was his grand prize. Later, in his office, Dr. James Anderson, Associate Managing Supervisor of Temporal Anomaly Research, cursed to himself under his breath. How could this happen? His own story, Revenge of the Ghostly Wrath, was exactly what the letter had told him to submit. Malthus must have seen his story and ripped it off. He had to admit that Tom's story was a little less silly than his own. Clearly, when he closed the temporal loop that had started when he got a letter from his future self, he'd have to send that story instead. And the winner of this year's Site 73 short story contest is Dr. Tom Malthus, for his story I Was a Teenage Carrot. The two dozen or so assembled authors clapped politely as Dr. Malthus rose from his seat, took a short bow, and accepted the $100 gift card that was his grand prize. Later, in his office, Dr. James Anderson, Associate Managing Supervisor of Temporal Anomaly Research, cursed to himself under his breath. How could this happen? His own story, Night of the Revenge of the Wrath of the Ghost of the Fury, was exactly what the letter had told him to submit. He thought it over for hours and hours before he realized he must have submitted his entry too early, and when Malthus found out there was already a story exactly like what he planned on submitting, he had to come up with something else. Clearly, when he closed the temporal loop that had started when he got a letter from his future self, he'd have to be more specific with his instructions. And the winner of this year's Site 73 short story contest is Dr. Sarah Evans, for her story Love at 80,000 Astronomical Units. The two dozen or so assembled authors clapped politely as Dr. Evans rose from her seat, took a short bow, and accepted the $100 gift card that was her grand prize. Later, in his office, Dr. James Anderson, Associate Managing Supervisor of Temporal Anomaly Research, cursed to himself under his breath. Director Edmonds had told him that he and Dr. Malthus had both submitted the exact same story, and since he couldn't tell which of them had plagiarized the other, he had no choice but to disqualify them both. He'd waited too long, and by the time he submitted the story the letter had told him to, Malthus had already submitted his original. Clearly, when he closed the temporal loop that had started when he got a letter from his future self, he'd have to be more specific with his instructions. And the winner of this year's Site 73 short story contest is Dr. Tom Malthus, for his story How Jester Got His Groove Back. The 24 or so assembled authors clapped politely as Dr. Malthus rose from his seat, took a short bow, and accepted the $100 gift card that was his grand prize. Later, in his office, Dr. James Anderson, Associate Managing Supervisor of Temporal Anomaly Research, cursed to himself under his breath. The letter he'd gotten from his future self had explained every last detail of how to ensure his victory. What had gone wrong? Perhaps it was inevitable that Malthus would win. Perhaps he'd always write a better story than the one Anderson submitted. Clearly, when he closed the temporal loop that had started when he got a letter from his future self, he'd have to send a second letter as well, one to remove Malthus from the picture altogether. And the winner of this year's Site 73 short story contest is Dr. James Anderson, for his story Night of the Revenge of the Wrath of the Ghost of the Fury. The 24 or so assembled authors clapped politely as Dr. Anderson rose from his seat on a pair of mechanical legs, took a short bow, and accepted the $100 gift card that was his grand prize. Success. Anderson was on cloud nine as he made his way back to his office. It was a small victory in his long career with the Foundation and all of the accomplishments they'd made to improve mankind, but it was a victory all the same. Immediately, he grabbed some digipaper and an e-quill, and started writing the instructions to his past self that would close the loop and ensure time remained unaltered. Assistant Site Director Edmund's thoughts radiated immediately across the great neural network to all those who had become part of the Foundation mind. And the winner of this year's Site 73 short story contest is Unit 483012, James Anderson, for his story Night of the Revenge of the Wrath of the Ghost of the Fury. Anderson hid his feelings from the accolades of his peers as they drifted into his mind. In the stasis pod where his physical body lay connected to the tubes and machines that sustained it, he rolled over and unplugged his neural jack. "This is all wrong," he thought as he suddenly found himself alone with his thoughts. "The world isn't supposed to be like this. My past self must have introduced some anachronism when he sent that letter. I've got to fix it somehow." Et la gagnance cet ni pour la concurte de nouvelles littéraires du site 73 au state. Dr. Tom Malthus, avec son histoire invituelle, nuit de la vengeance du Caroux du fantôme de la fureur. Les quoix de deux ans d'auteurs réunis applaudent poliment, tandis que le Dr. Malthus se levait, s'inclinant rapidement et acceptait la carte cadeau de 100 francs qui était son grand prix. Plus tard dans son bureau, le Dr. James Anderson, gestionnaire associé la supervision de la recherche sur les anomalies temporales, se mordit dans sa barbe. Malthus avait gagné? Son histoire n'était qu'une ridicule parodie de films de série B. Il avait mis tellement d'attempts dans sa propre soumission, un histoire autoreferentiel sur un homme prêt à tout pour gagner un concours d'écriture, simplement pour être surpassé par Storch on Bacolette outrancier came Malthus avait écrit en 15 minutes et soumis à jours avant la fin du délai. Eh bien, c'est dit-il se bel et bien terminé maintenant. Je n'y peux pas changer le passé. Ou pas est-il? September 8, 2013, the time contest has ended. The winner is Dr. Gears, with his Tale Foundation 2099. Thanks for all of your great entries. James Anderson cursed under his breath as he read the announcement on the front page of the SCP Wiki. His story about Lord Blackwood joining forces with SCP-173 to fight crime had been leading in upvotes for 2 weeks, and then Gears pops out of the blue again and posts a story that makes it to plus 100 in under 2 days? How is anyone supposed to compete with that? If only there were some way to travel back in time and submit Gears' own story before he could. The quivering purple mass of flesh towered over the 24 humans who kneeled in chains below it. It began to undulate as speech echoed from within its hulking body. I have reviewed the literary tributes you pitiful creatures have submitted to me, and none of them are worthy. None of you shall earn your freedom today. The slave who had once been called Dr. James Anderson, back before the coming of the age of flesh, cursed under his breath. Sure, freedom probably meant a slow death alone in the ruins of the world above, but it had to be better than this. There must be one of the master's playthings I can get at, he thought to himself, to ensure that he would be free. Dr. James Anderson woke up in his office and climbed out of bed. It was a sunny Sunday midnight and lunch break was over, time to get back to work and think about his entry in the writing contest he'd be hearing about next week. Outside his door, he heard the sound of a gong. The office courier was here. He opened the door and shivered as the cold winter air hit him. "LLL letter for you, sir," said the Hawaiian shirt-wearing courier as he handed him an envelope. Anderson smiled, tipped the boy 6 shillings and grunts, and sent him on his way. Closing the door, he sat back down in front of his typewriter and opened the envelope to find a single page, written in what appeared to be human blood, "We were fools to try and play with history. Millions and millions of paradoxes colliding with one another. Now it's all broken. Space and time are meaningless. It's just us, millions of Andersons alone in the empty desert below a sunless sky. He looks down on us, the great gray-faced god where the sun should be, and his gaze burns our flesh. He sees us now. Hide the nuclear launch codes in the credenza so I can kill him. IT's not working. He's immune. There is no hope for Sava." Anderson yawned as his alarm clock went off. 37:65 on Mars Day, Quachaur, December 72nd. Time for work. He laid the letter down on his desk and started typing out a copy of it to submit for the writing contest he'd be hearing about next week. We'll be right back.